Hello, Internet. My name is Perry. This is the first solo video I'm doing for TSG, and I'm pretty nervous. I'm sorry that I'm posting this video much later on Saturday than I anticipated, and I'm gonna explain that more as my video goes on. I'm really happy to be posting on TSG, so it's not because I was purposely slacking. This video is actually going to be super vulnerable and disclosey, and I feel really positive about that because I feel like this project allows us to really open ourselves to each other. So any feedback you have, I would really, really appreciate. So this week's question is, what has been the biggest obstacle in your transition and how do you plan to overcome it? When I first heard the question, I was like super overwhelmed by it because I don't really even know how to describe my transition or like what exactly my transition entails. So I had to think really long and hard, and I think out of all of the words that I think I could attach to like obstacle, I think that right now what I'm dealing with in my life is insecurity, and specifically with that insecurity, I think I would use the term regret of the past and fear of the future. Right now in my transition, I haven't chosen to do anything medical. I don't often pass as male. I think actually most often I get read as a trans woman, which is interesting. Like, I just get read as really androgynous all the time, and most people go by the sound of my voice. The reason I say insecurity is because I am really insecure around other trans people, cis people, coworkers, people I know at school, lovers, family, friends. I'm just really worried all the time about my gender presentation and how I'm being read. And this insecurity is like really deep within me, like how I feel like I feel about my own gender and if I'm happy with my presentation and if I feel like I'm doing enough in my transition to actually be considered trans. And currently the way I plan to overcome this is by dealing with the fact that I have only dealt with insecurity through addiction. And I feel like addiction is something I really, really, really want to start talking about within the trans and queer community specifically. I don't know a lot of other trans addicts, and that's really hard for me right now. And a lot of my addiction comes from places of insecurity, regret, fear of the future, just the unknown, and like, should I have come out sooner, and could I do more, and what am I going to do, and how will I do it? There's all these obstacles to overcome, and like with medical and the cis people being gatekeepers and all these barriers to healthcare. And those things have always felt really overwhelming for me and made me feel like I'm just not enough. Like, I'm a really underwhelming person, or I'm doing something wrong. So currently my biggest obstacle right now is insecurity and addiction, I guess, and I'm overcoming these things. I'm taking it day by day. I'm trying to stay sober, and I'm doing that with like great support of queer and trans friends and an amazing partner, and taking it day by day. Like, that's all I can do right now, is really nurture myself through my recovery, which today included like eating a lot of chocolate and eating junk food and not worrying about this video until later in the evening after I had gone to a meeting where I could talk to some people about how I was feeling. So I'm gonna leave it at that right now because I don't know how much more I'm gonna say about addiction, and I might not want to say everything that I'll end up posting on the internet, so I hope you all aren't disappointed with me. It's just like I'm 9 days sober into my recovery and feeling really vulnerable and feeling really insecure, and I would just really love some kind supportive words because that's really gonna help me overcome the biggest obstacle that's been like in my life. And my life is my transition is just so part of my life that I can't separate that. And I guess just to lighten my video a little bit and talk about the best movie I've seen, a movie that I've watched recently that helped me, which is like the best like quitting drugs movie for me, has been The Basketball Diaries, featuring the hot young Leonardo DiCaprio. It's not a new movie at all, obviously, but I watched it over the internet with my partner who's in Montreal, and then with like someone who's been really supportive for me here where I'm staying in Ontario, living at this autonomous social center as a facilitator. And another thing that's actually talking about living at this like social center that's going to help me overcome this obstacle is the fact that I'm facilitating a harm reduction focused workshop about addiction and substance use and abuse. And I'm really, really, really excited for that, and really excited for all the people who are going to come, because it's specifically like queer and trans focused. So I'm not going to edit this video very much. I'm going to leave it really rambly. My videos will be better, I promise. I'm sorry. I'm just like in a really like recovery place, and I can't focus too much on this video today just because it's stressing me out a little bit. But I love everyone on TSG, and I'm really, really happy to be a new person talking out of camera on the internet. So I love you all. Thanks for watching my video. Bye.